did not see a ruling like this in your lifetime.
And indeed we did. A surprise ruling today in the Danziger Bridge case. A federal judge ordered a new trial for the five former New Orleans police officers convicted 2 years ago of shooting and killing unarmed people in the days following Hurricane Katrina.
Judge Kurt Engelhardt cited the reckless actions of former U.S. prosecutor Sal Perricone and Jan Mann as the reason why today's landmark decision was made. The two resigned from the U.S. Attorney's Office after it was uncovered that they were making comments online using aliases about open investigations, including the Danziger case.
We have team coverage of this bombshell ruling. Reporter Casey Ferrand speaks to the Fraternal Order of Police and gets their thoughts on today's ruling. And we hear from the family of one of the two men shot on the Danziger Bridge.
But first, Travers Mackle joins us live at 5 with more on Judge Engelhardt's surprise ruling. Travers?
Camille, it's a bombshell decision that will have far-reaching repercussions. The very reason the judge did what he did today, prosecutorial misconduct dealing with the online commenting scandal that led to Jim Lenton's resignation and the cover-up that followed.
The former NOPD officers involved in the shootout and cover-up on the Danziger Bridge have achieved their biggest victory in the now reopened legal battle. This one handed to them courtesy of federal judge Kurt Engelhardt, whose ruling on Tuesday granted the five imprisoned cops new trials. The order left legal experts stunned.
You may not see a ruling like this in your lifetime.
That's because the judge ruled that the highly unusual, extensive, and truly bizarre actions of prosecutors warrant throwing out the officers' convictions. The reference relates to, among other things, leaks to certain media outlets and online remarks posted by members of the U.S. Attorney's Office during the course of the proceedings.
The judge took off the gloves to use that overused metaphor, and he really just hammered, I thought, the Department of Justice in this opinion.
As the I-Team first reported last year, both Jan Mann and Sal Perricone admitted to posting online rants using aliases. The court order says both may have made remarks about the Danziger case. The filing also notes that Jan Mann claimed former U.S. Attorney Jim Lenton was told about the online post and nothing was done.
It certainly causes people's eyes to roll back when they read this opinion or they hear your summaries about this opinion and Judge Engelhardt's view of how the government acted.
The Danziger cops were convicted in August of 2011 for shooting and killing innocent people in the days following Hurricane Katrina, then covering up the crime. The former officers granted new trials are Kenneth Bowen, Robert Josevius, Robert Falcon, Anthony Villavasso, and Arthur Kaufman. Some experts believe a new trial will be an uphill battle for prosecutors.
It's very difficult because you got to bring your witnesses back, but the jurors are going to know that a federal judge took them to task about what they did. And it's going to be incredibly hard for the new U.S. attorney coming in to make a decision about what to do. It's going to be hard.
Acting U.S. Attorney Dana Bente said he is unhappy with today's decision. Kenneth Polite is set to take over as the new U.S. attorney, possibly as soon as this week. He will handle any further prosecution of this case. Camille and Scott.
So, Travers, we've heard words today like eye-popping, jaw-dropping. You know, this decision is unbelievable in a lot of people's minds. It begs the question, what about former U.S. Attorney Jim Lenton?
We reached out to him. Obviously, he's the dean of the law school, or a dean at the law school at Tulane University. The report, as I mentioned, says Lenton knew about the online commenting. We went to his home and his office. Like I said, he's now a dean at the Tulane Law School. He has not responded to our repeated attempts to reach him. At 6, hear what political analysts have to say about how they feel this is a black eye for Lenton and his tenure as U.S. attorney.
All right. Thank